Anyway, the battle between Terre Haute and Bloomington tonight on the gridiron is Terre Haute North and Terre Haute South face Bloomington North and South. Which city would earn the bragging rights? Terre Haute South was at Bloomington North third quarter. South trailing 21-5 when the Braves go to work. Collins Turner, who threw for 169 yards, finds Casey Bender for a touchdown. Braves get the two-point conversion. They trail by 8. Fourth quarter, Braves continuing the comeback. Turner to his big tight end, Kenyon Schulte. South down 21-19. They go for 2 and tie it. They get in on the QB sneak by Turner here. How about this? Braves rally from 16 down to force overtime. South gets the ball first in OT. Jace Dressler, man, does he run hard. Rips off a 10-yard score. Good guys, 28-21. Dressler, 104 yards in the game. If South can get a stop, they'll win. Kenyon Schulte, who had a monster game on both sides of the ball, forces a fumble. South lands on it. Ball game. Terre Haute South wins a thriller, 28-21 in overtime. The Braves have won back-to-back games for the first time since 2014. Terre Haute North was at Bloomington South. Rough start for the Patriots. Down 21-0 in the second quarter. They need something to go their way. Jace Russell with a big kickoff return to get some life into North. QB Tristan Elder finds his running back Zach Simino out of the backfield for a first down deep into Bloomington South territory. Elder then shows off his arm. I like this kid. He's a great quarterback. What a beautiful deep bomb to Josh Humphrey, who makes a spectacular touchdown catch over the defender. Casey's sitting here nodding his head. You like that catch?
Nice ball.
That
nice
was catch. A great catch. Bloomington South, though, it's their night. They roll 52-14 over Terre Haute North. Patriots are now 1-2 on the season. Casey.
Well, Linton enters this season top 10 in the state in all-time wins, so you can understand why many are hitting the panic button in Minor Nation. They're 0-2 to start the year. It marks the first time Linton has dropped their first two games of the season since 1991. And things don't get any easier tonight for Linton as they host 3A number 10, Monrovia. The Bulldogs trying to add to a first-half lead, but look at Gavin House, the INT there. Great play to give the Miners the football. Down 21-0 in the second half. They're looking for some offense. A bobbled snap is no problem. Trey Goodman salvages it for a nice pickup for Linton, but the drive would stall, and that was the story of the night here. The Miners pinned back on the 1-yard line, and they give up the safety. That would cap the scoring as Linton falls to 0-3 on the year after the shutout. Monrovia defeats the Miners 23-0.
I mean, Monrovia is a great team. Don't get me wrong. It's just hard to believe Linton is 0-3. I mean, they'll get this turned around, and I wouldn't want to be facing them going forward in the next few weeks, but it is just hard to believe they're sitting 0-3.
A rare sight, but Linton falling to Monrovia. Once again, 23-0, the final. North Knox was looking for its first win of the season. The Warriors are on the road at Tecumseh. We go to the opening kickoff here. Cole Richter fields it, and he you know, sometimes you don't have to go the right way initially.
Are you supposed to go forward?
Yeah, well, he went sideways, but got it out to midfield. Nice starting position for the Warriors. Then the same drive, Richter gets the ball again.
He ran forward.
Yep, there you go. Brings him into the red zone. It's first down, Warriors. And to cap it off, why not? Ride the hot hand. Richter for the touchdown. It's 6-0 North Knox. They go for two because why not, especially when you've got a kid like Gavin Doan in the backfield. He goes around the far side to give the Warriors an 8-0 lead, and that was just the start for North Knox. Gavin Doan, another big night, 215 yards rushing and 3 touchdowns. The Warriors roll to their first win of the season. Final score 52-7 over the Braves. Well, Washington with a Big 8 conference game at Princeton. Garrett Brock, the Tiger QB, finds Dominic Hardman in the back of the end zone. A great catch to give the Tigers an early lead. Later, Bach passing to the near sideline. And check out the receiver here. Gets 1 foot barely inside the line. Hey. A great catch.
High school, it's all matters.
Yep, and that would lead to a field goal. The Hatchets struggle again tonight. They couldn't get on the board until late in this one. Washington drops to 0-3 on the year with a 36-14 loss to Princeton. Well, still to come, we'll head up north and let you know how North Vermilion, South Vermilion, and Riverton Park did.
And we have action from the land of Lincoln between Casey Westfield and Paris and the Zone. We'll be right back.